Okay. Hello, hello everyone. It's been a hot minute since I did my last video, but I finally made the time and found the time and found a gym to come and make a new one for you guys. So in this video, I'm going to do a bunch of different like reaction time drills that you can do by yourself. You can do a lot of these at your house. Some you might want a gym for, but a lot of these that you can do by yourself at your house. So I think that's all I needed to say. Let's get into it. All right, can you see me? You can see me. I don't know how well you can see on the wall, but right here I have 1, 2, 3, and 4. Just like 4 strips of tape taped onto the wall for my numbers. If you have a gym that actually has like numbers on the wall, or if you have a place that you can write numbers on the wall, if that helps you better, go for it. I just put tape on the wall. So something else that I did, I took my phone and I did a recording of me saying 1, 2, 3, 4 randomly. So it's like 1, 3, 2, 4, 2, 1, 2, 3. Just like that. I did like 5 videos of those. I'm gonna listen to them, and whichever number I say, I'm gonna touch the number. So we're gonna start with same hand, same side, so 1 and 3, I'm gonna touch with my left hand, and 2 and 4, I'm gonna touch with my right hand. So let's see if I can get the sound up here. Something else that I totally forgot to say. So after I do the sequence of numbers for a while, at the very end, I say go in my video. So it's like 2, 1, 4, go. As soon as I say go, I'm gonna turn around and I'm gonna sprint to the other side of the gym. I'm doing this so like my sprint is the short side of the gym. So yeah, I don't think you guys heard my phone audio, but you saw me tap it. So now we're gonna do the same exact thing, but we're gonna go opposite hands. So my right hand is gonna cross to touch 1 and 3, my left hand's gonna cross to touch 2 and 4. First thing, numbers 1 through 4 on the wall in a square. Start, same hand, same side, switch, opposite, opposite sides. So now, I'm going to try and set you up so you can see what I have on the ground. Okay. Oh, can you see me? You can kind of see me. So I have numbers on the ground. They're about a hand and a half apart. So what I'm gonna do with this one, instead of using my hands like we did on the wall, I'm gonna use my feet. I have 1, 2, 3, 4 going from left to right. So we're gonna start kind of the same way that we did our hands. We're gonna do same leg, so left leg for 1 and 2, same leg for 3 and 4 for the right side. And then we're gonna switch it up after we do one full session, and we're gonna go right foot for the left 2 numbers and my left foot for the right 2 numbers. So let's get into it. And again, I have go at the end of every sequence, so I'm gonna be sprinting to the other side of the gym. Okay. 2, 2. Now this one is going to be a little bit different. So we're going to still do the 1, 2, 3, 4 number sequence, but we're going to put a different action to every number. So when I say number 1, I'm going to jump. When I say number 2, I'm going to go down onto my belly and then get back up. When I say number 3, I'm going to go onto my back and get back up. And then when I say number 4, I'm going to turn and turn back. And I'm going to try and like switch it up, but we're going to turn and turn back. Just get our feet nice and fast and happy and get going. And then again, I'm going to say go. I'm going to sprint all the way to that wall. We'll try to sprint. I'm a little tired and beat up right now. So let's do this. Tip that I have for you on that one, mud breath. A tip that I have for you on that one is slow down your recording. I went a little fast, so I still like was in the middle of trying to get up from my back when I said another thing. So if you're gonna do this one, try to have a little bit more space between your numbers. We're gonna kind of switch gears just a little bit for this next exercise. I have a little foam softball. You could also do a tennis ball. I just couldn't find one. But anything that can bounce off the wall with ease. So instead of like doing a lot of fast randomized reaction time, we're gonna try and switch a little bit into more like hand-eye coordination. Because you can have the fastest reaction time in the world, but if you don't know what to do with it, you're not really gonna get anywhere. You're just gonna be shanking balls left and right instead of doing a good pass with your fast and fancy footwork. So, we're gonna be against the wall.
we have our hit, our ball, and we're just going to start underhand and same hand toss.
Let me turn you a little bit so you can see better.
I think that might be better. All right, so we're gonna start same hand, underhand toss to the wall, catch, same hand. Switch hands, do both hands, because in sports, it is awesome to be ambidextrous, even if you are naturally not. Work at it, you can get it, I promise. All right, now we're going to alternate hands from throwing and catching, so I'm gonna start throwing with my left, catch with my right, I'm gonna throw with my right, catch with my left.
Alright, somebody else just came into the gym, so I'm going to talk really quiet and kind of close. He's playing basketball, so it's probably going to be a little bit loud in here. We're just going to work with it. So now another thing you can do is just throw the, like, toss the ball behind you. Without seeing where it's going, quickly turn around and go and catch it. We're gonna do one more thing. We're actually gonna work with the volleyball this time. So we are going to hit against the wall. We're even gonna step back. I'm gonna have to shift the camera, but we're gonna hit against the wall and we're gonna pass. We're gonna move our feet to pass. And then we're gonna start stepping back and then we're gonna basically be like serving distance away from the wall and running up and passing this ball. Pads and arm sleeves on. Because the further back you get, and the more wild your serves and harder your serves get, the more you're probably gonna have to dive. yeah, those are some exercises that you can do by yourself. You don't need anyone. You just maybe need a few things and just get at it.